For the week of May 16th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
It's that time of the year again for Selection Board eligible first-class petty officers to submit any documents they may be missing from their service record for consideration by the Chief Petty Officer Selection Board. Fleet Activities Yokosuka's Command Master Chief Gregory Vidari said that making sure your service record is accurate is an important issue to address if you want to be selected.
Probably the most common error that sailors had was the simple fact that their records were not up to date. The most important factor for selection is ensuring that your record is up to date and accurate.
Vidari also said that in such a competitive environment, sailors need to strive to be the best in order to move their career forward and move into the next rank.
First of all, we're in a very competitive Navy. You know, advancements, you know, retention is very high right now. Advancements, it's tough. It's tough to advance. So you should be doing everything you can to make yourself the best all-around sailor.
Packages submitted to the active E7 board by the candidate must be postmarked no later than May 31st. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
The Navy Nurse Corps celebrates its 103rd birthday during a celebratory cake cutting at U.S. Naval Medical Center, Yokosuka.
Celebrating the 103rd birthday today, it really is very touching, and I'm very proud of all the hard work that the nurses have done to set our program into action.
Established by Congress in 1908, the Navy Nurse Corps has expanded with the needs of our nation from 20 female members to now estimated 1,500 male and female nurses throughout the military.
At this point in my career, it's all about mentoring the nurses that are coming into the Navy, because they will be filling my shoes. They're the future of the Navy Nurse Corps.
Today's Navy nurse is a modern asset to the Naval Medical Corps. From ship to shore, nurses are well known for their expertise in treating sick and wounded military personnel.
We're basically here to serve them and to take care of them when they're the ones getting hurt out on the front lines. We're the first ones that they're going to see and first ones that they're going to meet when they come into the hospitals out there.
Throughout history and into modern day, nurses continue to serve bravely and with great sacrifice, both in and out of uniform. Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Sailors attached to Strike Fighter Squadron 195 returned to Naval Air Facility Atsugi after completing a transition period at Naval Air Station Lemoore in California, where they replaced their older aircraft with the F-18E Super Hornet. The squadron's commanding officer, Commander David Culpepper, said the new aircraft means a boost in capability for naval forces in Japan.
We're very excited to be back in Japan. We've been gone for a couple of months transitioning from the F-18C Hornet to the Navy's newest strike fighters, the F-18E Super Hornet. Represents a fantastic increase in capabilities for a carrier wing 5, which is where VFA-195 is assigned as part of four deployed naval forces in Japan.
Lieutenant Andrew McCaffrey, a pilot in the squadron, said he enjoys flying the new Super Hornets.
They're wonderful. Our old ones were the best aircraft in the fleet, but the new ones are much more advanced and a lot more fun to fly.
Culpepper said he's glad to be back and happy for the hard work his squadron did to complete the trip. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Naval Air Facility, Atsugi, Japan.